You know the old Sesame Street game, one of these things is not like the other? Well, you'd have four kids, three of them jumping rope, one playing hopscotch or something. Well, suddenly, Salt Lake County looks like the hopscotch kid. A week doesn't make a trend, but it does make us ask, what is different here?
I'm not going to pile on. I'm just going to go from north to south looking at all the biggest counties in the state. Weber County, their biggest week. Davis, biggest. Salt Lake County, their biggest week.
Tracking county numbers every Tuesday for 3 months, and a major shift this week. The Wasatch Front's four big counties hold 75% of Utah's residents. Now, break down the Wasatch Front population. Salt Lake County has almost half, 48%. The blue line here represents new cases reported in Salt Lake County. Look at the last week, the only steep slowdown any of these counties has seen. All three others set new record highs last week. Consider the Wasatch Front divided almost in half now. Salt Lake County's 48% and the 52% of people in the other three counties combined. In this chart, Salt Lake in blue accounted for hundreds of more cases every week until last week. That orange line crossing the blue line shows what could be the first major shift in COVID's center of gravity in Utah. Here's another measure. Salt Lake County has had more than half of all cases in Utah until this last week. So why two major measures showing Salt Lake slowing while the infection accelerates elsewhere? Well, 1 week doesn't make a trend, but Salt Lake County Mayor Jenny Wilson mandated masks on June 27th. The CDC says most infected people show symptoms within 12 days of infection. So if a mask mandate works, you'd start to see it after July 8th.
The timing is right, and the mask mandate is the clearest difference between Salt Lake and those other counties. But it is too soon to say definitely. We will keep watching. In the newsroom, Max Roth, Fox 13 News, Utah.